An eerie mannequin of a boy, videos of children, and a box full of children's identifications were some items found in the home of Peter Haskell. But the body of a boy, the deceased Georgetown man is accused of murdering over four decades ago, was not found.
We were definitely concerned. I mean, especially when you see lights and an investigation going on essentially in your backyard.
Investigators spent 4 days at Haskell's Chestnut Street home earlier this month, following up on information from a man who said he witnessed Haskell murder a boy around 1970. That man first told police in 2007 that when he was 5 or 6 years old, Haskell took him into the woods at Bald Plate Pond, where he witnessed a young boy with sandy brown or blonde hair between the ages of 12 to 8 tied up. The witness said Haskell then picked up a rock, saying, "This is what happens to bad little boys," before smashing the back left side of that boy's head, killing him. The witness also told police he smelled burning flesh coming from Haskell's basement.
Just hearing all these different things come out, I mean, it's kind of crazy just to know that, you know, something like that was so close to your house.
The search warrant states Haskell denied the allegations when first questioned about them in 2009. A search of his home back then turned up nothing. The search earlier this month did turn up bones, later determined to be from an animal.
It makes you question what else could have happened.
Court papers also include interviews with people who allege Peter Haskell wasn't only a murderer, but a pedophile, and the likely suspect in an attempted kidnapping. Live in Georgetown, I'm Reed Lamberty, WCVB News Center 5.